Good morning, students. Our gross anatomy lecture of mandibular nerve. Title is mandibular nerve. We start with the mandibular nerve in such a way that first we draw here our trigeminal ganglion. This is the trigeminal ganglion. Just below the trigeminal ganglion, we draw one nerve root. From this end of trigeminal ganglion, we draw a thick nerve root which will pass from the trigeminal ganglion. Once again, arrow is directed like this, and I fill in with yellow shape. Therefore, this is our initial starting of mandibular nerve. What will be the definition of mandibular nerve? We know that this mandibular nerve is a branch of trigeminal nerve, which is the fifth cranial nerve, which is divided into maxillary, mandibular and ophthalmic divisions. Mandibular nerve contains both the components, sensory as well as motor. Sensory component will be larger, motor will be smaller. Therefore, the sensory nerve will be thicker, motor nerve will be thinner. Starting point of mandibular nerve will be from trigeminal ganglion. This trigeminal ganglion is present in the intracranial cavity. It will be present on either side of the hypophysis cerebri, and this ganglion is present on the superior surface of apex of the petrous portion of temporal bone. Details we will discuss regarding this ganglion and the Meckel scale which is covering this trigeminal ganglion in intracranial cavity. Right now, these points we have to understand for the starting of mandibular nerve. Therefore, sensory and motor. The sensory component will be larger, motor component will be thinner. The larger sensory component will take origin laterally, the thinner motor component will be situated medially, and they will take origin from trigeminal nerve nucleus, which is present at the level of pons. From there, these two components which are coming out, they will form trigeminal ganglion here. Because it is sensory, it will carry all the efferent sensations from the peripheral part towards the ganglion. From the ganglion, it will relate to the nuclei within the pons and extension till midbrain and medulla oblongata. Those nuclei which are present in right from midbrain, pons, medulla, they are trigeminal nerve nucleus. They will be discussed in neuroanatomy. For example, those nuclei are mesencephalic nucleus of trigeminal nerve, then chief sensory nucleus of trigeminal nerve, then spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve, in which the sensory component which will pass through trigeminal ganglion will relay. We are focusing on formation of mandibular nerve. That is why we have to start from here, from trigeminal ganglion, the larger sensory component. Below the trigeminal ganglion, the motor component is passing, which will lie below the trigeminal ganglion and below the sensory component. Now, both these components will pass through. Here I will make this foramen. This is a very important foramen, foramen ovale. So I will write here foramen ovale, O-V-A-L-E. And here I will mention this as sensory component of mandibular, and here I will mention this as motor component of mandibular nerve. So as the motor is lying below, now sensory component passing and motor component will also pass through foramen ovale. So it is passing through this foramen ovale. Again, the relation in foraminovel will be the upper component is sensory, lower is motor. As it passes through foraminovel, below in infratemporal fossa, both of these components will join. And therefore, after joining, it will form the mandibular nerve. This will be the mandibular nerve. Both the components have joined with each other. Therefore, now our mandibular nerve is lying in the infratemporal region below the foramen oval. It will lie lateral to one muscle which is situated deep to it. Name of that muscle, tensor velli palatini muscle, or short form tensor palati muscle. So therefore, that muscle will be related deep to mandibular nerve, tensor velli palatini. Surface marking, according to surface marking now, exactly at this point, there will be the anterior portion of the head of the mandible. This is how the mandible is present. This is how the mandible is present. So if I complete this diagram, it would go like this: head of the mandible, anterior margin of the head of mandible, just in front and behind will be the mandibular nerve. This is the outline, very faint outline I'm making, I'm drawing. This will be of the mandible, ramus of the mandible. This is a very faint outline of the mandible. So on the surface, this mandible will be, mandibular nerve will be on the anterior margin of the head of the mandible. Now comes the division and its branches. This mandibular nerve is divided in according to three main divisions. On the right hand side, if we focus here, I will just write it down. Number one, the first division will be from the main trunk, from the main trunk of mandibular nerve. There will be passing out of two branches from the main trunk. The first branch will be, nervus spinosus. The other name of nervus spinosus will be meningeal branch of mandibular nerve. Please write it correctly. Meningeal branch of mandibular nerve, or it is called nervus spinosus. And second branch from the main trunk of mandibular nerve will be the nerve to medial pterygoid muscle. This is the second branch. Now, after giving these two branches from the main trunk, our mandibular nerve will divide into two branches. This will be the anterior division. Anterior division. And another branch, which will be the posterior division. This will be posterior division. So therefore, from the anterior division of mandibular nerve, branches will be the first branch, which will be sensory, and it is called buccal nerve. Buccal nerve, which is sensory, the only sensory nerve from anterior division. Number two, there will be muscular branches, and they are mesenteric branches supplying mesenteric muscle. Number three, they are temporal branches which will supply temporalis muscle. And number four, there will be nerve to lateral pterygoid muscle. These three are motor branches: mesenteric branches, temporal branches, and nerve to lateral pterygoid. Then we come to posterior division of mandibular nerve. Posterior division of mandibular nerve, very interesting. It is very interesting, and three branches will be there. The first branch, that will be auriculotemporal nerve. This will be auriculotemporal nerve. Remaining two will be terminal branches. So the terminal branches will be named as the two terminal branches now. Number one, that is total number two, lingual nerve. Lingual nerve, that is smaller terminal branch. Now the larger terminal branch will be number three, and that will be known as inferior alveolar nerve. These are the branches of mandibular nerve, and these are the main, this is the main component how to describe mandibular nerve. And here, if I collectively place a comms and write it as mandibular nerve, this is the flow chart which you have to note down. After describing the mandibular nerve, this diagram, line diagram, we write here branches of mandibular nerve, and we write in this we write in this flow chart. Now each and every branch we are going to discuss slightly in detail. So therefore we start with the main trunk. Now if we come back to this original diagram, the main trunk here, this much is the main trunk of mandibular nerve. From the main trunk, as the first branch is nervous spinosus, or it is called meningeal branch of mandibular nerve. This branch, I will draw here, it will pass behind the head of mandible, and it will enter one foramen which lies posterior lateral to foramen ovale. Name of that foramen will be foramen spinosum. So I will write here as foramen spinosum. And this now here, I will mention this now as nervus spinosus, or meningeal branch of mandibular nerve, which will enter foramen spinosum along with middle meningeal artery. And there will be passing of middle meningeal vein. So therefore, this now will pass through foramen spinosum inside in the middle cranial fossa, where it will supply the dura mater of the middle cranial fossa. This much is about first nerve, nervus spinosus, or meningeal branch of mandibular nerve. Second branch from the main trunk, as we have written, now to medial pterygoid. Now to medial pterygoid. Here, I will mark this from the main trunk. So I will mark it as a small arrow which is projected in this direction. And simply, I will give the name as the nerve to medial pterygoid muscle. Now this nerve to medial pterygoid, it will directly pass to medial pterygoid muscle from its deep surface. It will supply the medial pterygoid muscle from its deep surface. Also this medial pterygoid nerve will supply a branch which will pass through the otic ganglion. This otic ganglion will come in relation to mandibular nerve in the next segment. Now this branch which passes through otic ganglion without any relay will supply two more muscles. And the name of those two muscles, once again from here, we will write here, or we can draw here, one and two. These two branches passing through otic ganglion, but the name of two muscles we have to write and remember. They are tensor palati, that is tensor veli palatini muscle, and another branch which will supply the tensor tympani muscle. These two muscles are supplied by branch from nerve to medial pterygoid, which will pass through otic ganglion. It has to pass through otic ganglion without any relay, and it will supply tensor villi palatini muscle and tensor tympani muscle. So here we finish our branches from the main trunk of mandibular nerve.